SIGMO Victoria, SiGung's partner here at the Australian Jow Ga Academy. SiGung's delighted that John has reached this great landmark as a Kung Fu master. Welcome to Master John and to his family, his wife Danielle, his daughters Missy and Piper, Angela, the girl's grandmother, John's sister Tessa, his brother David, and wife Sam. He's shown exceptional loyalty to SiGung and the international Jow Ga Kung Fu family over 2 decades. As a person, as a student, and as a teacher, Sifu John demonstrates honour, loyalty, respect for self and for others, and a lifelong dedication to the art and the family principles of Kung Fu. So we'll welcome some words for you from SiGung and from Sifu John, and we'll start with SiGung.
And welcome to Pop Dizzy Island. Just kidding. But I've always wanted to say that. Okay, here we go. John's inauguration as a Jow Ga Kung Fu Master today is a momentous occasion for me and John. Our journey together spans across 19 years during which we have enjoyed a close and positive relationship. I can genuinely say that it has been and still is an absolute pleasure to teach him. John has made his achievement despite living in America for part of his time and despite always having many commitments outside of his devotion to Kung Fu. John is a friend to many, family man, businessman, and of course a Kung Fu man. But actually, my name for John is Chip. That's Chip to you guys. Sifu Chip. Not just Chip, Sifu Chip now to you guys. That's because in spite of his busy schedule and definite time limits, John manages to continue to move forward little by little, chipping away at the hugest of tasks bit by bit. In fact, he's chipped away at almost 36 levels of Kung Fu with me so far. If John has 15 minutes of practice, then that's what he does. He doesn't use it as an excuse to do nothing. Many of us can learn from this. It's a good method, not just for Kung Fu or for sport, but for anything that we want to achieve in life. For me, John is a model student and Kung Fu man. He continues to jump in and lend a hand whenever he can, in spite of his strict time schedule. John has traveled with me and alone to represent Australia with Jow Ga Kung Fu around the world, in America, China, and very regularly in Hong Kong. He'll step in and assist the school performing Kung Fu to promoters or a traditional lion dance for significant occasions like Chinese New Year. In turn, I have been honored to help him do some of his own personal trials, as he has also helped me with mine. I and all Jow Ga family members really appreciate John's contribution, and I'm very proud of him. He's like a son to me, and this is part where we got choked up. We got to get this like men and not cry. One of the things I like most about John, his sensitivity, and in contrast, his directness. He lets you know his time limits, pulls no punches, and if he invites you, if you go out with him, or he invites you over to his house, John, it's absolutely no mistaking it. John will say, okay, everyone, and look at his watch, and he said, all right, everyone, it's 9 o'clock, time to go, wrap it up. But that's John, that's what I love about him, that's okay. So without further ado, and before my time runs out, because I know we got a tight schedule here, I'd like to take this time to congratulate Sifu John Chip Callaghan.
This is going to be pretty tough. Thank you to everyone for coming today. It's, I appreciate it so much. I can't even put it into words. But warning, I'm going to cry. I've already started, so this is just the beginning. It's going to get a bit worse. A Sifu acceptance speech is a reasonably difficult thing to write. There's no templates out there. So I had to sit and think for a long time, what would I talk about today? And I came down to a question. And that question was, why do we do Kung Fu? And I think that to do Kung Fu, basically you have to be crazy. Maybe just a little bit crazy, but you do have to be crazy. And I've seen over my 19 years that martial arts really does attract crazy people. The way a moth is attracted to a flame. None of us really get into fights, and if we would, we wouldn't be fighting with swords or spears. So why do we do it? No one forces us to come up here. But we come up and we sweat, and we face exhaustion and doubt and pain. You know, really, you have to be crazy. But I think that we do it because when you start training in martial arts, you know that you're taking a path, and that path will eventually lead you to a test, and it's going to be a test of your fear. That could be a grading, or a demonstration, or a fight, or a competition, or even giving a speech. You believe, and you have faith, that your training will give you the tools to face that test and that fear. So you're going to walk up to it, and you're going to look it in the eye, and you're going to feel that frisson. You'll be scared, but the fear is going to energize you. And you'll do that test, whatever it may be. Sometimes you'll succeed, sometimes you'll fail. But even if you fail, you stood up to that fear. So even when you lose, you still win. And later you realize that what you did in the test actually wasn't important. The important part was that you prepared, you showed up, and you did it. And in this way, Kung Fu is transformative. It changes people.
Preach on, brother.
I'm a completely different person to the man who walked in that door in April 1996. Looking back to that day, which I still remember quite vividly, I've got to say, life is a funny thing, and it leads you to some pretty unexpected and interesting places. For example, me up here right now giving this speech. I still need some time for this to sink in, and if you'd have told me back in 1996 that I'd be here today, I just wouldn't have believed you. It would have been beyond comprehension. So how did I get here? I don't really know. But I can tell you where it started. My wife Danielle went to the US in 1995, and she brought me back a VHS videotape of the MTV Movie Awards, where Jackie Chan had won a Lifetime Achievement Award, and they had a little montage segment of clips from his movies. And I watched it, and my life changed instantly. It wasn't an OMG moment, it was an OMFG moment. I had to do it. So what do you do in 96 when you want to be like Jackie Chan? There's no internet, and information is pretty tough to come across. So you pull out this thing called the Yellow Pages. And for anyone who's under 20, it's a big yellow book. It's got lots of phone numbers in it. And you look at martial arts schools. And I tried some Kyokushin Karate, but that wasn't the Jackie Chan stuff. I tried some Wing Chun, a little bit closer, but that wasn't the Jackie Chan stuff. And then I found the Australian Jow Ga Kung Fu Academy. And as soon as I walked in that door, I knew I'd found a place for me. Looking back over the 19 years, the things that stand out are not the kicks or the punches or the forms or the techniques. It's the sense of family and community that I've found in this room and between the Jow Ga schools in Europe, Asia, and the US. I've met so many interesting people, young and old, different stories and paths that cross because of our interests in a form of physical culture developed by five brothers in Guangdong, China, and curated by all the Jow Ga Sifu since. The experiences I've had meeting with the Jow Ga family have enriched my life. Anyone can learn to fight and anyone can get fit, but not many people can experience the sort of cultural exchange that I have.
No time for that!
Excuse me, I have to take this. My overwhelming feeling today isn't pride or satisfaction. Like most of us, I'm my own harshest critic. But rather the feeling is gratitude. I initially planned to list all the people from this school who I learned from and trained with and instructed, who helped me get here, but the list just got too long. I'd be reading names all day. So I'll just say to the instructors who taught me, to my fellow students, past and present, and to my disciple brothers, thank you. To my wife Danielle and my daughters Missy and Piper, thank you for putting up with the evenings that I train, the trips to Hong Kong and China, and the interrupted weekends. I appreciate your sacrifice that helped me get here. Thank you to Sima Victoria for working hard to keep the Australian Jow Ga Kung Fu Academy here for all of us. It is a thankless task, but everyone here is here today because of your hard work. It always amazes me how the school can offer so much to so many different people, big, small, male or female. There is a place for everyone in this school, and that culture comes largely from you. And my final thanks is to SiGung Bennett. SiGung is my coach, but he is also my friend.
And we cry together.
SiGung's skill is without question, but that isn't what makes him a great teacher. As a coach, it's easy to be hard on people and to bark at them and tell them what they're doing wrong. The difficult part is making a connection. SiGung, every hour that I've invested in Jow Ga is also an hour that you've invested in me. SiGung often says that it's hard to find a good teacher, but harder to find a good student. Well, I'm sorry, Sifu, but that's a crock. I've been out there, and I know. I was very lucky the day that I looked through the yellow pages and I found you in this school. You're a great coach, you inspire me, and you honor me today with this gift. Thank you.
SiGung and Sifu John now bowing to each other, the Kung Fu salute in their new roles. And SiGung will now present John with his certificate, his Kung Fu mastership certificate, and his very first red and black Sifu ceremony.